Why you upset like Cinderella teens? You should see the things I fit inside these denim jeans.
Sorry. Jacqueline and
Gabby.
Okay. How much do you swim at the moment and what kind of experience of swimming do you have?
I think you should have very low expectations. we used to swim once a week prior to COVID.
Okay.
After COVID, I haven't really gotten into it again.
Okay. And when you were younger, did you swim at all?
No.
No lessons, nothing like that? No. Gabby, exactly the same. Okay.
So now we are here in Colonia San Jordi in Mallorca, and we're going to start some swim training, basically kind of reinstill the basics, make sure technique's on point, the athletes are efficient. We only have 5 weeks until the game, so it's not going to give us a huge amount of time, but hopefully they go in optimized swimming, because the chances are we're going to see some swim event.
How was it?
Just trying to get into it. It's fine. Nice and starting with 1-1. Kind of getting into it before after start the main set. It's usually fine. I find the first one's worst. And then once I get into it and get warmed up, it feels a bit smoother.
Jacqueline, is there any reason you breathe every three?
I get better flow if I don't breathe so often. So for the swimming, you know, if I could even breathe every four, every five, you know, because you kind of get into my flow. I feel like the breathing is destroying the flow a bit, so. And then, it's the same. When I'm relaxed and starting, my heart rate isn't as high, I find it more comfortable to breathe every three. But what I usually do when I do length is, like, maybe the first length and a half, I would breathe every 33, and then I go to every second. Just me and most.
You feel like you're getting the oxygen.
I am getting enough.
Day one of games training, so it's a great place to start. And it's always useful to get the eye of other coaches. So no matter like the specialist swim coach, it's really nice to get the input, have someone else look at the athletes and kind of touch base with how they're doing. So we can go away and work on that stuff, and hopefully in between the time of us leaving that we'll be able to come back here as well.
So really engage that core, you want to try and elongate it a little bit. Okay? Try and keep everything high in the water. You swim well, I think a lot of it will just be conditioning. It'll just be swimming and swimming and swimming, because technically...
I hope there wasn't like magic trick to make me good at swimming without having to swim.
Well, you know, the more you condition yourself and the more you swim, then you get into the position where little technique things will make the difference on how you swim more efficiently, more efficiently.
He's quite happy with everything, which is nice. The athletes, I don't think, were super excited to hear that it may just be time in the water versus any magical technique cure. I think they were both looking forward to a magic technique pointer that would help them, but you know, it seems that hard work is going to be the only answer.
So my arms and lats would kind of cramp up, so I don't have the muscle endurance for that.
You've got the muscle, but not the muscle.
Yeah. So for me, it's only one side, because I'm breathing on the right all the time to the left shoulder.
Okay. To that. So if you are tired, you kept the technique pretty good all the way through. So it was good. As I thought, maybe you'd start to fall apart a little bit on the third or fourth one, but you didn't. You kept your stroke and your technique well together. We're going to do a few drill swim things now, just to work on a few technique things. Okay.
I thought for a second you were going to say we're going to do a few more of those.
Now we're going to do some. We're just going to do some technique work. Couple of
three
things.
Of
well, the first thing is you've got to make friends with the water.
Yeah.
Okay. The water is your friend. Okay. You're not gonna beat it if it's your energy. There's no way. Okay. So use it as a friend and work with it. All right. All right. We're gonna go down. We're gonna go 250s. The first half of the length is a drill, and it's just gonna be doggy paddle drill. Okay. doggy paddle drill is really, really simple. You're just swimming like a dog, okay? But what I want you to do is rotate from your hips. You put your head out of the water, you're looking forward, you're reaching out as far as you can, and you do that by rotating your hips, okay? It's just this movement. Your arms don't come out of the water, your recovery is under the water, okay? Come back. Propulsion here, recovery under the water. Okay, so you're just swimming, it's called doggy paddle. And each time you do this, I want you to reach as far forward as possible and then push far back as possible. Past your hip. Try and keep everything nice, line, nice and straight, okay? All right, looking forward.
Not gonna lie, I feel a bit stupid. My favorite part of CrossFit training, games training. No, it's fine.
Good, I'd like to come down and have a look at everything.
I think if I keep telling myself it's fun, then maybe eventually I believe it myself. So I'm trying to change my thinking about swimming, and I'm trying to enjoy it more than like suffer. And like, we're not gonna get better in it unless we're gonna change how we think about it. So it's a long process.
Do this skill here. You just kick your legs and you're just moving your hands like this. Play around with it so that you start to feel it, and you'll start to feel it in your forearms. You feel it in your forearms?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. Good. Feel that in your forearms? Okay. And every good swimmer is good at sculling. It's just to find the feel of the water. And if you can scull, then you'll be able to do it in lots of different positions inside the water, and that just gives you a much better feel for where you are on the propulsion part of your stroke. And basically, the more you do it, the more you'll start to feel the water. You're not getting any power here, okay, on your propulsion part. You've got to imagine you've got a center line here, and you're staying outside of the center line. Swimming's all about making nice shapes in the water. Okay, so as soon as that shape comes off, this arm's over here, this hip comes over here, but also, the worst thing is your legs kick really, really wide. You open your legs really wide, and that's a lot of resistance, okay? So what you're gonna try and keep in your head is keeping the resistance minimal. I got stamina, turtleneck on with my camera, yeah. Stay creamy, man, that's what they say. Shoes laced up and I came to play. Yeah, I'm first team, I'm a superstar. They call me cream, like Abdul-Jabbar. Yeah, you have to face it, let's get back to basics. I'ma take the shot like it's a vaccination. I don't have the patience, I'ma shoot right now. My advice would be, unless you've got to sprint something really, really fast,
yeah.
If you're doing like John's just shown me on a video there, you've got to be conserving your oxygen and conserving your energy. So basically the swim part is getting down there as quick as possible with the least amount of energy. Okay? Now if you're kicking really, really hard, that's where all your oxygen goes and all your energy goes. Okay? And you're just gonna be tired.
Are you done?
Yeah, you can get out now and I'll have a chat with John about how we can proceed.
Ooh, freedom. Now, I was thinking this takes forever, but it's obviously busy. I was thinking maybe it's like this, 6 meter pool. Obviously don't swim that much. Day one. I mean, we just started day one. The ones we got at Games in 2019, but I really like this. I've had them for 6 years now.
One job. Two cleans plus one power jerk. The first clean they're going to try and hold power, the second clean they take into a squat clean, and then obviously the power jerk. But as I said, it's mainly just focusing on, this is the first time they've touched a barbell in probably like 8-9 days, something like that. So it's just easing back into it, making sure that the body feels smooth, rather than focusing on the heavy weight.
at 80 kilos at 75. This time we go power clean, squat clean, power jerk, yeah, three sets. So I think I might just give the background story so people have a bit of an idea. So we're just about to finish day one of games training, and you know, it's great we've had both Jacqueline and Gabby qualify for the games. We now have an unexpected hurdle of actually getting into the US. So to give you guys a bit of background, Gabby qualified in 2020, and you know, there was lots of things moving around, lots of moving parts, and we had many discussions with CrossFit HQ. In the end, they decided to run an online portion and a live portion. Before they decided to do that, we were in talks about how we get into the US. And in essence, because CrossFit's not classified as a professional sport, the athletes are classified as amateur athletes. It makes entry into the US very hard when it's only essential travel, right? So even with a visa, ESTA, it can be very hard to get in. Now, fast forward to 2021, you know, we've put all the work in, we've worked through all the restrictions, and it's like deja vu, we're in the same place. We've got 10 deadlifts, 10 double kettlebell swings, 10 hand cleans, and then 10 shoulders overhead. So now we're having to start to plan multiple different routes of travel to see what can happen. One option is that we have to fly to Dubai. That's going to be 14 days in Dubai, and then in theory, once we've been in Dubai, we can then travel to the US, because everyone in the Schengen region is currently not allowed to travel in unless they have a sense of travel. We're trying to get back in contact with CrossFit HQ to see if they're able to help with Homeland Security and get us in. But I kind of expected the last week to be a bit more relaxed, but since we haven't had any information, it means that we've basically become like logistic planners of how we can get these guys into the States ready to compete. It's kind of a tricky situation for us to be in, and you know, we're doing our best to reach out to all European athletes and kind of form like a group so we can make sure that we get over there and have a European presence. But that's kind of the current logistical situation we're in. We'd have liked to have had our training here in Mallorca leading up to a few weeks before, because it's kind of the perfect place to train. But now we're sitting on the fence to see if we actually have to fly to Dubai this weekend to do the 2 weeks and then go into the States, or if we are going to finally get a letter that can go to the Homeland Security and see if we can get directly in. So it's been a bit of an interesting week. We hope by in the next two to three days we should have more of an answer. But until then, everyone's kind of on standby as, you know, are we leaving this weekend or are we not?